Hello, welcome to Analog Tech. Today we will see how to draw a plus line in a MATLAB. So you can see here a plus line has been shown, which is the output of the program which we will going to discuss today. So you can see here this is the plus line. It will be like this, and it has plotted with a dotted line, so it has shown here. So you can see here center line. So first we need to identify the center line. Here the x-axis is this one. This is your x-axis and this is your y-axis. So depending upon the type of line which you want to plot, if we plot plus line on the y-axis and the x-axis and combine together, then we can draw a plus line. So let us see the range given here. The range is from 0 to 4 on the x-axis and same 0 to 4 on the y-axis, and with a center at 2, 2. So this is the x-axis and y-axis center. So let us see how we can code this to make a plus sign. So coming on the coding part, you can see first we have taken one variable, that is line, which will give a value 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it will give a 5 value in a MATLAB with y axis equals to 2. Since we are taking y as a constant, it means if we are making a plus sign on the axis x and y axis, here the value of y is fixed. It means we are going to plot first this line. Okay. So plotting this line, we have to start with 0. So I have taken a 0 starting point and ending point is 4 with a difference of 1. So this will be your first line. So plotting this line, we need to keep y equals to constant and x needs to be changed. So for that, in the plot function, we have used line 1. Line 1 give a 5 value, that is 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And with a constant value of y, but it will also having a 5 value, because plot function will work only on variable. It means the number of row, a number of values in line 1 and number of values in y into 1's size of line 1 will be same. So for that, we have made this second part of plot function into a 5 value. See what the value is coming from this part. This will give the value of, since it is multiplied with 2, so it will give 2, 2, 2, 2 and 2. So it will also give 5 value. And since we are plotting these two like 0, 2, so x is 0 and y is 2, so the first value will give here and the second value will 1, 2, so x will be 1 here and 2 will be somewhere here. And similarly, for you can see third value 2 and 2 again, so 2 and 2 again here, and it will move so on. And since we are plotting with a m represent for magenta line, if we replace the color line, we can just replace it by naming the color here, and we are just plotting with help of dotted line. So if we just remove this, then it will also plot a single straight line with a black color. Now, since we want to make a plus sign also, so we need to make a line which is called a vertical line. So we will be plotting like this to make it plus sign exactly. So similarly, since here in the first part, that is in the first line, and this if I mark it as a second line, so for first line, we have made y as constant and x as variable. Similarly, for the second line, this was for the first line. Similarly, for the second line, we have to make x as constant and y as variable. So you can see the command for the second line. Since we need to plot one over another, so I have used hold on function. And since we have to make this time x as constant, so we have used x equals to 2, so it will be starting at x equals to 2, so it will be somewhere here. And while plotting x, I have make it constant 5 value, so again it will x value will give 2 comma 2 comma 2 comma 2 comma 2, and line 1 will be variable from 0 to 4, 0 1 2 3 and 4. So we need to plot x with respect to y. So first plot will be 2 comma 0 at value 2 comma 0, and the second value will be at 2 comma 1. So 2 comma it will be here 1 somewhere here, and then 2 comma 2 will be here, and then 2 comma 3 will be here, and 4 will be here. So this way, this is the representation of your first line. This will plot like this, and this will plot like this. And if we combine, since we have used a hold on function, if we combine both, then it will give plus line like this. So let us see the output in the MATLAB, how it is coming and what is the role of this m dot dash dash. Since we want to plot a dash line, so we have used dash dash. If we don't use it, it will give a simple straight line with a confirm value. So let us move on to a MATLAB window. So I have used clear all and close all function with a line which we have discussed in the code, that is 0 to 4. So it will give 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 with a y constant, and plotting the value on line 1 and y into ones of size of line 1. So size of line 1 will give 0 to 4 value. So it will give 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and depending upon it will give the output. So let us see by running it. So if I run this command, you can see the output here. We are able to get the plus sign. Now if we want to change the center, or we want to just change the color of this line, you can just replace it with, if I want to make a red line, I'll just replace it with R, and then again just run. So you can see this is a confirmed red line and this is the different line. So if I want to x axis to make it at red and y axis with a green line, so I just mark it with G and just running the code, you can see here the y axis is with a green line. And if you want to just remove this coloring, so you just have to remove this comment line, or which is the function of the plot to make it color change, and don't want any color or any dash line. So if I just plot it by removing these two, so if I run this, you can see a form line. Okay, this is the form line which is differentiating the line of first and second line. So you can see directly that this is plus sign can be made with the help of these commands. So I think hopefully you have understand the code as well as the output, so you can make any kind of plus sign with the help of these concepts, making y constant and x variable, and x constant and y variable. So in latest MATLAB function, it has directly used the command using line. So you need to understand the concept behind making a line and making a targeted plus sign. So thank you for watching this video. I will be covering the next topic, that will be based on how to plot a circle. So thank you for watching this video.